Hello friends, welcome back to Relief Tutorials. Yesterday we have discussed exercise 13.6 question number 1 and question number 4. Now we will discuss exercise 13.6 question number 2. See, the inner diameter of a cylindrical wooden pipe is 24 cm and its outer diameter is 28 cm. The length of the pipe is 35 cm. Same we have drawn, if you know that yesterday. This is outer, okay, and inner. Outer and inner, see here. It is given that outer diameter is equals to 28 cm. So therefore outer radius, mean that capital R, is equals to 28 by 2, that is 14 cm. Clear? Now inner diameter is equals to 24 cm. So therefore inner radius small r is equals to 12 cm. And length of a pipe. Length means height of a pipe is 35 cm here. It is 35 cm height. So height h is equals to 35 cm. Find the mass of the pipe. You have to find the mass of this pipe. If 1 cm cube of wood has a mass 0.6 gram. So 1 cm cube mass 0.6 gram. See, try to understand friends, these are the dimension given, outer diameter, inner diameter and length, and this is the density. Density, you know, mass upon volume, so 0.6 gram per centimeter cube, this is the density is given. So first we will find volume, this many, 1 centimeter cube 0.6 gram, so what is the volume of this hollow pipe? So how you can find volume of this hollow pipe? So first you know that, see, this is a hollow pipe. If you want to find the volume, so I will find this volume of this material volume. See, this is made up of a material and this is the material. If you want to find the volume of material, how you will find out this? You will find volume of outer cylinder minus volume of inner cylinder. So this will be subtracted. So you will get this volume of material. Clear? So if you want to find volume of material, you will find this volume. You will find this volume, total volume occupied, space occupied by this. Then you will subtract this space. So if you will subtract this whole space, if you will subtract, you will get the volume of this material. So outer volume minus inner volume. So now we will find volume of wood. So volume of wood is equals to outer volume minus inner volume. Clear? Outer volume minus inner volume. So now what is outer volume? So volume of cylinder, you know, area base into height. So pi r square h minus, this is volume of outer cylinder, this pi r square h, that is area base into height, minus pi r square h. This is bigger radius, outer radius, and this is inner radius. That's all. This difference you have to keep in your mind. Clear? So now you will take common, pi h common. So you will get here r square minus r square. Clear? You can write this way also, pi h a square minus b square, a plus b, a minus b. That will be little bit simple. So pi, so value of pi is given 22 by 7. Height is 35, r plus r, so r is 14, small r is 12, so 14 plus 12 and 14 minus 12. Otherwise you want to find square here, r square, r is 14 square minus 12 square, simple you can find out. So 22 by 7 into 35 into 14 plus 12, 4 plus 2, 6, 1 plus 1, 26, 14 minus 12, 2, 7 ones are here, 5. 5 2s are 10. Now 26 into 22 you have to find out. So 26 into 22 is 26, 2, 6, 2s are 12. 12 you will get here 2, 7, 5. 5720 centimeter cube is the volume. Have you got it, friends? This is the volume. Now you know that mass of 1 centimeter cube. Mass of 1 centimeter cube of wood is equals to 0.6 gram. That is 6 upon 10 gram. 0.6 gram means 6 upon 10 gram. Clear? So therefore, mass of 5720 centimeter cube of wood is equals to 5720 into 6 upon 10 grams. 0, 0 cancel. 6 2s are 12, carry 1, 7 6s are 42, 43, carry 4, 6 5s are 30 and 4, 34, 3, 4, 3, 2 grams. Clear? If you want to write in kg, so 3, 4, 3, 2 upon 1000 kg, because you know that 1 kg is equals to 1000 grams, so that is equals to 3.432 kg is the mass of this hollow pipe. Simple, no? What you have done here, what you have learned, new thing here, you want to find this volume of this material, this volume of this material you have to find out, this material. So what you will do, all this material, see this material. You want to find volume of this material. Clear? This material volume you have to find out. So first you will find out volume of outer cylinder minus you will subtract this. You will subtract this volume of inner cylinder, so you will get volume of material. So volume of wood is equal to outer volume minus inner volume. That's all. Clear? So we have completed this. Question number 2. Now question number 3. Exercise 13.6. Question number 3. See, read the question. A soft drink is available in 2 pack. Okay, for a tin can with a rectangular base. So tin can with rectangular base means can with rectangular base. So can with rectangular base means it is cuboid. Okay, so can with rectangular base, so that is nothing but it is cuboid. This is cuboid. So we'll see the dimension. What is the dimension given here? Length of this tin is equals to 5 cm, width, breadth is equals to 4 cm, and height is equals to 15 cm. So now you have to find. Soft drink is available in 2 pack. A tin can that is cuboidal with length, breadth and height is given. Then you have to find a plastic cylinder with circular base. A plastic cylinder with circular base means this. See, this is a cylinder with circular base. So it is a cylindrical. Is it clear? Second is a cylinder. Base diameter 7 and height is 10 cm. Each container has greater capacity and by how much? So first we will find volume. So volume of cuboidal can. Volume of cuboidal can. Cuboidal can. So volume of cuboidal can is LBH. Yes. So LBH. So length is 5 into 4 into 50 centimeter cube. 5 into 4 20. So that is equals to 300 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of cuboidal tin. Clear? Now can with circular base. Cylinder with circular base, can with circular base, circular base. So that is what, that is nothing but it is cylinder. It is cylinder. So what is given here? Cylinder diameter. So this, now diameter is given. So diameter is equals to 7 centimeters. So therefore radius r is equals to 7 by 2 centimeters. Don't write 3.5. Again, it will be in decimal, 3.5. And in order to remove this 3.5, you will write 3 and a half. 3 and a half, 3 to the 6, 6 plus 1, 7. So, that is 7 by 2. So, after this many process, you will reach here at 7 by 2. So, naturally, if diameter is 7, radius is 7 by 2. Directly, you write. So, this you got radius. Now, height. Height is 10 centimeter. Height is 10 centimeter. Height. H is equals to 10 cm. So now you will find volume. So therefore, volume of cylindrical can. Cylindrical can. So that is equals to area of base pi r square h. Pi is how much? Here it is given 22 by 7. So pi is 22 by 7. Radius. So radius is 7 by 2. So 7 by 2 into 7 by 2 into height. Height is 10. So this 7, 7 cancel. 2 ones are, 2 elevens are. Here 2 ones are, that is 5s are. So 11 into 7, 5 is 35. So 11 into 35. So that is equals to 35, 35. So that will be 385 centimeter cube. So how much it is 385 centimeter cube? So we can say that volume of plastic cylinder has greater capacity. So volume of, if you read the question, you will come to know what you have to find out here. We have to find which container has greater capacity and by how much. So we can say that cylindrical can has greater capacity as greater capacity by how much? So by 385 minus, we can see here 385 minus 300, that is 85 centimeter cube of capacity is more. Simple. So just we have find out the volume of cupboard and volume of cylinder. So now exercise 13.6. Question number 4 we have done. Now we will find question number 5. Question number 5. So read question number 5. What it is given? It costs rupees 2200 to bend the inner curved surface of a cylindrical vessel 10 meter deep. With the cost of bending. So inner cylindrical vessel. See, this is cylindrical vessel. Cylindrical vessel, it is 10 meter deep. So deep is 10 meters. So height we can say deep means height. So here height is given here. So we can say height h is equals to 10 centimeter. 10 meters, sorry. Height is 10 meter deep. And if the cost of painting is at the rate of rupees 20 per meter square. And total cost is given. And for 1 meter square, see it is this fella. 1 meter square is rupees 20. And total cost is rupees. Is given that 2200 total cost. So for 1 meter square it is 20 and total cost is this much. So if you divide this 220 by 20, you will get total area. Total area. So you read the question, it costs 2200 to paint the inner curved surface of a cylindrical vessel. Okay. So total cost is rupees 2200 at the rate of rupees 1 per meter square. Clear? So total cost is given to bend inner curved surface area is equals to rupees 2200 and cost of bending 1 meter square is equals to rupees 20. This is the data. Clear? So now we can find CSA. So inner curved surface area is nothing. Now we can understand the total cost is 2200 and 1 meter square cost is 20. So if you divide 220 by 20, you will get the total area. So therefore we can say inner curved surface area is equals to total cost, that is 2200 divided by 20. This cancel. So that is equal to 110 meter square. So inner curved surface area is equals to 110 meter square. And you know, inner curved surface area of a cylinder is nothing, perimeter of base. So perimeter of base means it is circular, no? Perimeter of base. So perimeter of base is 2 pi r h is equals to 110 meter square. So 2 into pi. So value of pi is 22 by 7. 22 by 7. Radius, we don't know. Height is 10. So that is equals to 110. So in this whole equation only one thing is unknown, that is radius. So we can find the radius. So radius is equals to 110 into 2 upon 1. So 1 upon 2. 22 upon 7. So 7 upon 22. 10 upon 1. So 1 upon 10. 0, 0, 10. 11 ones are, 11 twos are. So here radius is equals to 7 upon 4 meter. So we got radius. So you want to find radius of a base, so 7 upon 4, so therefore 7 upon 4 means 1.4 7 divided by 4, 1.75 meter is the radius. Clear, very simple friends. Total cost of painting inner curve surface area is 2200 and 1 meter square cost is 20. So if you divide, you will get total area, that is curve surface area, and that is 2 pi RH. So we have height, so we will get radius. We have found radius. So you want to find inner curve surface area of a vessel. So inner curve surface area of a vessel is 110 meter square, that is 2 pi RH. Inner curve surface area is equal to 110, radius is equal to 1.75, and you have to find capacity of a vessel. So capacity of vessel is equals to volume of cylindrical vessel it is. Capacity of vessel, so that is nothing but volume of cylindrical vessel. Volume of cylindrical vessel is pi r square h. Clear? So pi is here 22/7. Radius is 7/4 into 7/4. You will not take 1.75, you write in fraction 7/4. Height is 10. 7 cancel, 4 ones are here, 4 twos are here, this 2. Clear? 2 ones are here, this 5. Okay, so 7 cancel, 4 2s are, this is 11. Sorry, 4 2s are, this is 11. 2 1s are, this is 5. So 11 into 7 into 5, 35. 35 into 35. 35 into 35 is 385 upon 4 meter cube. So now you will divide this. So 385 upon 4. So you will do the division. See here, 385 upon 4. 385 divided by 4. 4. 9 fours are 36. 9 fours are 36. 2, 25. So we can say 4. 6 fours are 24. 24. 1.0. 4 twos are 8. Now 2, 0, 25. So that is equals to 96.25 meter cube is our answer. So capacity of a vessel is 96.25 meter cube. Clear? So capacity of a vessel we have find out 96.25 meter cube. If it is asked in kiloliter, so you know 1 meter cube is equals to 1000 liter. We will convert this into liter. See, if it is asked in kiloliter, then what we will do here? Kiloliter, just I am doing this work here. 96.25 meter cube. 1 meter cube is equals to 1000 liter. You know that 1 meter cube is equals to 1000 liter. This conversion we have discussed already. So this many meter cube. So how many liter? So we can say 96.25 into 1000 liters. This is the answer. So 96.25 into 1000 liter. If you want kiloliter. Kiloliter, 1 liter, kiloliter, kilo means 1000, so that is 1000 liter, 1000 liter is called kiloliter. So 96.25 into 1000 liter, so this 1000 liter is called kiloliter, so I can write 96.25 kiloliter, KL or kiloliter. You got it, friends? 96.25 meter cube is our volume, but if you want to write in liter, so 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liter. So 96.25 meter cube is equal to how many liter? Multiply by 1000 liter. So 1000 liter is kiloliter. So this 1000 liter is called kiloliter. So 96.25 kiloliter. Okay. So here we have completed this. Now we have discussed question number 5. Question number 6. Exercise 13.6, question number 6. Read the question. See, what is question? The capacity of a closed cylindrical vessel of height 1 meter. So height h is equals to 1 meter. And capacity means volume is 14.4 liter. So closed cylindrical vessel. Is equals to 14.5 liter. This is liter. How many square meter of metal sheet would be needed to make it? So you want to find out how many square meter of metal sheet would be needed. to make this container, it is a closed cylindrical tank sheet. If you want to make this closed container, how much metal sheet is required? So you want to find this curved surface area, this top and this bottom. Why? Because it is a closed. It is mentioned that closed cylindrical tank. So you have to consider this top as well as this bottom. So you want to find total surface area. Clear? So you want to find out total surface area. So TSA is equals to question. Okay, once again you read the question, you will come to know how many square meter of metal sheet. So everything should be in meter. Height is given, volume is given. So volume of vessel. So here you see what we will find. Volume of closed cylindrical vessel. Closed cylindrical vessel is given 14.5 liters. So volume of closed cylindrical vessel means volume is pi r square h is equals to 14.5 liter. See, one thing I want to mention here, answer here it is in liter, but radius will not be in liter, height also will not be in liter, they are in meter, height is in meter, radius is in meter, there are two radius, r square, so r into h, so two radius and one height, all these three things are in meter, 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 so meter cube, so answer should be in meter cube, so this has to be converted into meter cube, and you know the conversion, 1 meter cube is equals to 1000 liter. So 2000 liter means 2 meter. So I will got that 2000 liter divided by 1000. So this liter has to be divided by 1000. And value of pi is given here. Okay. So 1 meter cube is equals to 1000 liters. So here it is in liter. You have to write in meter cube. Clear? So what we'll do here, or you can write this also, 1 liter is equals to, you know that 1000 centimeter cube, this conversion also you know, 1000 centimeter cube is equals to 1 liter. So 1 liter is equals to 1000 centimeter cube. Then here you have to change all this meter and all this. So we'll keep as it is. As you wish, if you want to convert into centimeter, you can convert in centimeter also. Or if you want to write as it is as meter, you can write the same thing. Okay. So what you have to do here, conversion is necessary, friends. As it is, okay. See now. So here pi, you know the value of pi, 22/7. Radius, we don't know, r square. Height, 1. And this 14.5 liters. So you have to convert this 14.5 liters into meter cube. So you have to divide by 1000. 14.5. Upon 1000, see this way, 14.5 upon 1000 liters. See, this is liters, we are converting into meter cube. So that is meter cube. Clear? 2000 liters. How many meter cube? 1, 2 meter cube. 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liter. 2000 liter means 2 meter cube. That you have to divide by 1000. Clear? So we have divided by 1000. 14.5 divided by 1000. Clear? Then you will get the value of r square you have to find out. 22/7, 1, 7 by 22. 14.5 into 7 by 22. Clear? So little bit difficult value you will get in solving all these things. So you can convert into centimeter also. That will be quite easy. So we will do any conversion. See, 1000 centimeter cube, 1 liter. So this many liters, how many centimeter cube? How many centimeter cube? Clear? Okay, so height is equal to 1 meter, so 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So I will convert into centimeter, that will be little bit easy, see. Now you know that 1000 centimeter cube means 1 liter, 2 liter means 2000 centimeter cube, 3 liter means 3000 centimeter cube, 14.5 liter means 14.5 into 1000. So now pi 22/7 into r square into height is 100 centimeters. So this is in centimeter, centimeter, centimeter cube. So now 14.5 into 1000 centimeter cube. So here liter is converted into centimeter cube. Clear? So r square is equals to 14.5 into 1000 into 22/7, 7 by 22 into 100 by 1, so 1 by 100. See here 14.5, so we can say 14 and a half, 14 to the 28 plus 1, 29 upon 2 also you can write. Okay, if you want to write. So r square is equals to 14.5 means 29 upon 2 into 1000 into 7 by 22 into 1 by 100. 0, 0, 0, 0, that's clear. Anything else? No, 2 ones are here. 2 ones are, these 5s are. 5. Yeah, this is the conversion we got. So 29 into 5 into 7. So 29 into 5. 9 5s are 45. Carry 4 5 together 145. So I can write this way, see r square. R square 29 into 5 into 7. 29 into 5, 145. So 145 into 7 by 22. This is r. We don't want to find radius, otherwise r is equals to root you have to do. And it will be very difficult to find the root of this value. So r square as it is. Why? Because in question it is not mentioned that you want to find r. How many square meter of metal sheet would be needed? You have to find that. How many square of metal sheet is needed? So you want to find r, sorry. Okay, so 145 into 7 upon 25. We can do with 11. 11 2s are 11, 1s are 11. Then it will be 335. No. So cancel. 9 5s are 45, 5 carry 4. 9 2s are 45, 5 carry 4, 5 2s are 10, 145. 154. Any mistake? Oh, I have made a big blunder, friends. I have made a big blunder. Here, volume of cylindrical vessel is not 14.5 liter. Volume of cylindrical vessel is 15.4 liter. 15.4 liter. See, this is the biggest blunder. That's why we are not able to cancel here. Have you got it, friend? Not 15.4, it is a volume of closed cylindrical vessel is not 14.5, it is 15.4. So it is 15.4 into 1000. So here you will get 154 into 1000 into 7 by 22. Clear? So this I will cancel. Sorry, extremely sorry, friends. So now what value we got? Now see, just I have mistaken, I have taken data, wrong data I have taken. So now we can say r square is equals to 154 into 1000 into 7 upon 22 into 1 upon 100, sorry. Now 0 cancel, 0 cancel, 0 cancel, 0 cancel. Okay, then 11 2s are 11 2s are 11, 1s are 11, 44, 14s are. Clear? 2 1s are. Here it is 7s are. So r square equal to 49 you got. R square is equals to 49. So r is equals to 7 centimeter. So we got radius. Have you got it, friends? I am sorry. We got radius. Now we want to find, what we have to find? We want to find out how many square meter of metal sheet would be needed. Okay, so area of metal sheet needed, area of metal sheet required is equals to total surface area of cylindrical vessel. So total surface area of cylindrical vessel means cover surface area 2 pi rh plus 2 pi r square, area of base and top, that is here. Total surface area means cover surface area, area of base and area of top. So pi r square plus pi r square, 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. So now common we can take 2 pi r. So we left here h plus r. Got it, friends? So now we will substitute the value. Okay, we have radius, we have height. So now 2 into pi. So pi value we know 22 by 7. 2 into 22 by 7, radius is 7, height is 100, radius is 7. So 2 into 22 by 7 into 7 into 100 plus 7, 107. 7, 7 cancel. So 2 into 22, 44 into 107. So now 107 into 44, 7 4 is 28, 1 4 is 4. So 4, 28. So 8, 10, 7, 4. So answer is 4708 centimeter square. This is area of metal sheet required. But if you read the question, you will come to know how many square meter. So square meter. So again, we will see, you know that 1 meter square is equals to 1 meter into 1 meter. So that is equals to 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter. 1 meter, 100 centimeter, 1 meter, 100 centimeter, 100 into 100. So 10,000 centimeter square. So 1 meter square is equals to 10,000 centimeter square. So this many centimeter square. So we want to convert into meter square. So 4708 upon 100 into 100 meter square. So that will be equal to 40. So 0.4708. 4 digit. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is meter square. So this much amount of metal sheet will be needed to prepare that cylindrical tin. Have you got it, friends?